Anybody recognize this? It's a calcium score. They take numbers and start looking at the amount of calcium that you had in your CT technology. What are the uses? Screening after a moderate Framingham risk. Well, we know what that means a little bit more now. Number two, to rule out risk. I actually use that not quite often. One of the more common reasons for me ordering a calcium scan, the vast majority of calcium scans that I see are people that got them out in the real world and brought them in to me because they couldn't get a CIMT. When I order them de novo, it's usually because, and it's a fairly unusual case, but it happens. Somebody will come in, and they'll have plenty of reason, and they will too, to think that they probably have some plaque, but it'll come up negative on the CIMT. We may look at the femoral as well, still look negative. Sometimes we'll go ahead and just get a calcium score just to make sure. Because that does happen. It's unusual, but it happens about 2% of the time. Tracking progress. There's a fellow named Budoff that you'll see that's done a lot of research on this. He says you can track progression. You know what I'm talking about here? Once you know you have plaque and you start changing your lifestyle, you start doing stuff different, you want to see, have I made a positive impact? You really can't use this on a practical basis. He's made that statement. And has anybody seen John Lorscheider's? Yeah. That made a big impact because he actually dropped his calcium score significantly. But he's very unusual. It just doesn't happen very much. It's not because he did such great work. It's just because that doesn't happen very often. Again, we've said this multiple times. You asked that question earlier, and it all gets back to test, don't guess. Know what kind of risks you've got. It helps you move away from the refrigerator. So, and a couple of other things to remember. It measures calcium. It doesn't measure plaque. So it doesn't measure soft plaque. And yes, I have seen patients that had significant soft plaque and it didn't show up. A lot of people look at my channel and Ivor Cummins. And if I were to delineate differences between my channel and Ivor Cummins, I'm a little bit more focused on CIMT because of reasons like this. If you haven't seen, who in here has seen the movie The Widowmaker?
Good.
The rest of you need to watch it. This is just a comment about internal academic medical politics. This was the editor of the magazine. He got mad because the information started leaking that calcium score actually works. It does. It is helpful. He embargoed it for almost, like, he held it off for another year. How many people lives could have been saved by getting that information out there? Once he got it out there, though, it's not his fault anymore. Somebody else's. Please take a few minutes. It's worth watching. Again, women are the superior gender. I bow to my wife every day. Well, not really. But very clear, at age 50, I get people that have, and you see it on the comments on the channel, I'm 50 years old, I have plaque. Oh my Lord, I'm dead. I'm walking wounded, I'm toast. Well, you know, if you're a man and you're 50 years old, you probably do have plaque. You probably do have calcium. Anybody not understand what that shows right there? But for women, 30% of them have calcium at age 50. Anybody have any guess why? Serious or otherwise? Estrogen and testosterone. There's some inflammatory component to being bigger and heavier, even if sometimes more muscular. But that gets into a little bit deeper autophagy and inflammation related stuff. So Agatston scores. Just one comment I want to make about this. You also see people that say, my calcium score is over 1,000. A lot of people have calcium score over 1,000. I have a lot of people with calcium scores over 4,000. And yes, they were nervous about it when they came in, but after a few years of stable life at 4,000 plus, they've they're pretty used to it.
If you don't know this already, take it from me. You don't want to suffer a heart attack or a stroke. You don't want to hope for treatment after these have already happened. Heart attack's the number one cause of death, still. And stroke is the number one cause of permanent disability. And when we talk about that, we forget about the fact that it causes so much agony for your family. So why wait for a heart attack and stroke to happen when the knowledge and tools are there and they're available? If you're worried about the tests, the cost of tests, the consultations, the cost of that, I understand it shouldn't have to cost that much. Taking first steps for your health should not be that expensive. My name is Ford Brewer. I'm a board certified preventive medicine doctor. I used to teach this at Johns Hopkins. I've taught hundreds of doctors in prevention. I've helped thousands of people avoid death and disability from heart attack and stroke. With the success of the Kentucky event this past November, we're motivated to spread the good news about heart attack stroke prevention. Join us on February 28th in Orlando, Florida for another heart attack and stroke prevention conference. For only $740, this is an excellent opportunity to have your CIMT and know the actual risk for cardiovascular health. Learn about plaque, inflammation, insulin resistance, and taking charge of your health in ways that you may not know. And that's not all. Sign up for the full package. You'll have more. Not only the necessary lab tests, but I will be your doc and Janice will be your health coach in moving forward and getting control of your health and preventing that heart attack or stroke. Believe me, heart attacks and strokes are optional. So register now. And know your status before it's too late. See you in Orlando.